Hello my dear students, welcome once again to my class. Today I am going to discuss about vocabulary, translation and comprehension. That is there in the syllabus of SEBA, that is State Education Board Assam. So today, in today's class, we will be discussing about in these three topics. First of all, we are going to start with vocabulary. In vocabulary, so many things are there, word meanings are also there. That means the style of using language in various ways. This is known as what? Vocabulary. But here in the syllabus, under the topic of vocabulary, it comes this homonyms. Homonyms means what? The pronunciation of words are same, but the meaning is different. And sometimes the pronunciations are not same, but meaning is very near to each other. So we are going to discuss about all those things. Here in vocabulary also, like my last class I said there is no specific rules for verb phrases. Here also in vocabulary there is no specific rules. We have to understand, we have to know the meanings of these particular words, then only we can use. And homonyms, it is very important for us. You know why? Because sometimes the speakers also, or the writers who is writing, or the person who is speaking, he is also becomes confused regarding the usage of these words. So here you have to be very careful about the meanings of this particular word. Otherwise, we may think that we have written the right thing or we have spoken the right word, but actually the meaning will be totally different. So here I am going to give you some examples. It is not possible to do all those things. So here I am going to give you some examples, and rest you have to practice at home. For that, no, you should get some questions. If you do not get questions, then how will you manage? So for that, once again I am telling you, you can buy one question bank, and in the question bank you will get a lot of homonyms. You can practice them at home. Question bank that is there with me, I regularly tell my students to buy this one. So question banks are there for class 9 also, class 10 also. Whatever book you it is available in your locality, you can buy this one or you can manage this one. If you can manage, then it will be better for you. So let's start with vocabulary. First of all, we are going to start with effect and effect. A double F E C T, effect, and another one is E double F E C T, effect. One more thing I want to tell you, the question comes in two ways. First thing is, question will be asked, make a sentence using the following pair of words, make a sentence using the following pair of words showing the difference between them. One question. Another type of question may be there, that a sentence will be given, and at the end of the sentence these two words will be there in front of you in the bracket, and you have to choose the correct option. So question may come, choose the correct option from those given in brackets. So these two ways question comes for homonyms. So now we must know the meanings of these, otherwise we cannot use them in sentences, or we cannot use them in the particular place. What is the meaning of effect and what is the meaning of effect? Effect means what? The change of anything after certain activities and effect means what? Effect the characterization T-I-O-N characterization after effect. So effect means what? The change of anything after certain activities. Something has been done on some other thing and it has changed. This is the effect of the activity. And effect means what? When something has, that means the characterization after effect, the effect has been done, then what change after taking place, the change what had happened, this one is effect. So it will be better, you can understand it better if we use both of them in sentences. So let's try. First one is what? Effect. My warnings, have no effect on him. Now we have to write the sentence using effect. Okay. My warnings have no effect on him means what? My warnings has not changed. My warnings has not brought any change on him. Now effect. My warnings have affected him. That means I have given him warnings and some changes have come on him. That's why we can say that my warnings have affected him. Another example we can take, example of principal and principal. So principal means what? Head of the institution. Principal means what? Head of the institution. Principal means the head of anything, and principal means rules, regulations, discipline. All these come under principle. So when we'll use this in sentence, then the difference you can understand better. So he is the principal of our school. He is the head of our school. Principal, he is the head of our school. Now principal means what? Rules, regulation. We can say that he is a man of principle. That means he is a man of rules and regulations. That means he is a man who follows rules and regulation. Or we can say here in this case, we can say that our principal is a man of principle. The person who is the head of our school, he is a man who follows rules and regulation. One more example we can take. Imminent, and its homonym is what? Imminent. So this is also what? a homonym, a pair of homonymous words. First one is what? Imminent. Second one is what? Imminent. Imminent means what? Imminent means familiar, famous, popular. And imminent means what? Very near, very close. So we can understand the difference. A big difference is there between the meanings of these two words. So when we will use these two words in sentences, then we can understand it better. First one, let's see what I am writing. You can use these words in your own sentences also. He is an imminent man or imminent figure. He is a popular figure, he is a familiar figure. Now, imminent means what? It is very near, that means something which is knocking at the door, very near. So, we can say that our exam is imminent. Our exam is very near. Another example we can take, example of eligible and illegible. Eligible, E-L-I-G-I-B-L-E, eligible, and its homonymous word is what? Illegible, I-L-L-E-G-I-B-L-E. Eligible means what? Eligible means the person who is appropriate for something. Eligible means what? Appropriate. And illegible means what? Unclear, that is not clear to others. It is relating to handwriting. That means if I am discussing something and if it is not clear to you, you cannot say that it is illegible. It is regarding handwriting, or it is regarding about printing of something that is not clear. Illegible. He is, for illegible we can write a sentence, he is eligible, E-L-I-G-I-B-L-E, he is eligible for the post. That means he is appropriate for the post. Now, second one is what? Illegible. I said what? It is unclear, and it is unclear regarding what? Writing or printing of something. So, we can say that his handwriting is illegible. These are the sum of examples of homonyms. So, question will come in this way also, and another way question comes, how I said this sentence will be given and you have to fill up the blanks using the words. The words will be given in the bracket and those words will be homonymous. You have to choose the meaning of the word, understand the meaning of the word and choose the perfect word. So, for example, we can take a sentence, our family deals in dash products, and you will get example, you will get options as DIARY dairy and DAIRY dairy. So, the pronunciation of both are near to similar, dairy and dairy, but spelling is different. So, which one will be used? For that, what to do? We must know the meanings of both of them. So, first of all, we must know the meaning of DIARY. Dairy means what? The diary what we bring to a school, or the diary what we maintain, the book or the copy where we write our day to day activities. This is what? Dairy, we maintain diary. And DAIRY, dairy means what? The products, those are produced from milks. So, here my family deals in means business. So, my family business is what? Related to products, those are produced from milk. So, here the appropriate answer will be what? DAIRY, dairy products. Difference is what? Diary means what? A book or the copy where we write about our day-to-day activities or about ourselves, or the diary what we bring to our school, and the school authority maintains this one. They give marks, homeworks, then assessment results, etc. So this is what DIARY diary. And DAIRY diary means what? This is what related to milk products. That means the products those are produced from milks. So here our family deal in means what is known to us. Deal in means what? Business. So our family business is what related to milk products. And one more example we can take. He has an easy dash to, he has easy dash to the ministers, to the ministers. And here you will get options as EXCESS, and another one is ACCESS. So we have to choose the correct option. For that, what to do? We must know the meanings of these two words. What is the meaning of excess and what is the meaning of excess? EXCESS, we know that it is excess of anything that is more than enough. That means the thing which will fulfill my desire, this is what? Enough. And more than that, it is what? Excess. And ACCESS means what? The opportunity or the freedom to enter into some places. This is what? Excess. The opportunity or the freedom to enter into some places. So here he has an easy dash to the ministers. So he can enter into the ministers easily. He can enter into the ministers' rooms easily. And here we cannot use the EXCESS because this doesn't mean the entry of anything. Here it means the he can enter into the ministers' room easily. ACCESS, access to the ministers. Then we can take example of another sentence. The dash of my shop is not good today. The dash of my shop is not good today. Here options have been given as sale and sell. So to choose the correct option, what to do? We must know the meanings of this. So let's come to sale. This is noun. That means the sailing. That means when we SELL means what? Verb. It is a verb meaning what? Sail. Sail, it is noun, and sell, it is verb. Then you meaning what? When customer comes to the shop and he buys something and he takes away, this activity is known as what? Sell. And activity is known as what? Sale. And when the shopkeeper does this, this is what? Selling. This is what? Sell verb. So here the dash of my shop is not good today. We cannot say that means sell. Here we cannot use the verb, we have to use the sale. SALE meaning what? The activity of buying things by the consumers. The sale of my shop is not good today. Another example we can take. This is also like this, a bit confusing. Like sell and sell. We have to be clear that sell, S E double L sell is verb and S A L E sell, sale is noun. Another one we can say that we can take example of the teacher gives us dash. Example option A D V I C E advice, and another one is A D V I S E advice. Advice means the good thing, what the elders, teachers, and sometimes our companions also can say that is good for us. This is what advice. So A D V I C advice is noun and A D V I S E advice is verb. So we have to understand the meaning of the sentence, and then we have to put whether we have to understand whether to put verb or whether to put noun. So here the teachers, the teacher gives us advice or advice. So here the teacher gives, already verb has been used, so we have to use what? Noun. And one more thing we have to be careful, that here students commit mistake frequently. So advices, we can use the plural form of advice, advic, advice, as it is noun, so we can use the plural form of advice also as advices. And advic, advice is what? Verb. So it doesn't have its plural form, so it has its second form in, and it has its third form also. So we cannot use, if it is in second form in past tense, we cannot use adviced. That means we want to say he advised me. Adviced we cannot say, because advic advice is noun and there is no past form of advice advice. So there we have to use what? Advised advised, because advice advice, it is noun. The act of giving advice is what? Advice advice, verb, action. We know that verb is what? Action word, when some activity is there. Then we can take example of accept. This is also a confusing one. A double C E P T accept and E X C E P T accept. A double C E P T accept and E X C E P T accept. So let's make a sentence. Dash him, I have two more friends. And here two options we got. One is accept, A double C E P T accept, and another one is E X C E P T accept. So we must know the meanings of this to use these use one of them as the correct option in the sentence. So what will be the answer? A double C E P T accept means what? To accept something. I have given you something and you have accepted this one. This is what? Accept. And E X C E P T accept means what? Leaving aside. Leaving aside means what? That means you have something, you have three things, you have two books. So if I take one, you can say that except this I have one more book. So this is the meaning of accept. So here what will be there? I am not going to use accept, because here accepting of something is not there. Means what? He has three friends, and except him, if you leave, then he will have two more friends. So it will be what? Accept, E X C E P T accept him, I have two more friends. And one more thing, if we are using this one at the beginning of the sentence, we have to use the capital letter at the first letter. Though in option it will be written in small letter, but while using we have to be careful. We have to add, if we are using this one in the beginning of the sentence, then the first letter will be capital. If it is there in the middle of the sentence, then we have to use the small letter. So this is all about, one more example. This is the last example I'm giving you. One more example: alter and alter. alter alter and alter alter. Alter alter means, alter means what? Change. Alter means what? Alternative. We say no, alternative came from alter. Alter means what? Change. And alter alter means what? It is original meaning of this, a high table where it is the, it remains in the church where Christians keep their breads etc. for Jesus Christ, or whatever they take to the church, they keep this one on the on that table. That is higher position where idols are kept. We can say that the position, the higher position where idols are kept. So this is related to idols, and alter means what? Change. So let's try, we have to use them in sentences. We can say that he has altered, altered, altered his plan. This is what? He has changed his plan. And they offer prayer before altar. They means what? That means anyone, Hindus, Christians, other people. So they offer their prayer before what? Altar. Altar, it is related, we can say that this is idol. This is all about what? The homonyms. These will be the two ways how the questions will come. We have to use them in sentences to show the difference between the meanings of these two words, or a sentence will be given and will be given two words. We have to choose the correct one. So the some of the examples I have showed you. So now what to do? You are to practice this at your homes. For practicing, now you should get some questions. So for that, I told you already, you buy one question bank or test papers or somewhere else if you can manage questions. So from there also you can do them. So today I'm going to discuss about another topic, another two topics. One of them is what? Comprehension. Comprehension means what? Comprehension means what? Understanding of something. So here the examiner will test our understanding level. How this will be there? How the questions will be there in our exams to understand or to examine our understanding level? Simply, a paragraph will be given to you. It is not like substance writing. A paragraph will be given to you, and then some questions will be given on the on the topic, on that topic which is mentioned in the paragraph, and you have to find out the answers from this paragraph. This is all about comprehension. That means how much you have understood from this paragraph. This is the thing the examiner wants to check. So here what to do? First of all, without reading the questions, we have to go through the paragraph first. Then we will understand something. Then once we have to read the questions, all the questions we have to read once. Then once again, after reading the questions, we have to go through the paragraph. Then some ideas will come to us. That means these are the questions, and there the answers of these questions are. Then for the third time, one question that means while reading for the second time, I have understood something. That means this answer of the first question is here, second answer for the second question is here, and answer for the third question is here. So for the third time, when we will go through, when we will read, then the first question, the place where we have marked as the answer of the first question, we have to go through that particular portion, and we have to find out the answer. So here we have to be very careful. That means we have to understand the comprehension, we have to understand the paragraph, then we have to answer the question according to our own language. Sometimes that means we can mix our language with the language of this paragraph, but not always. So, for the third time when we will go through the question and with the answer, then we will find some, find the answer. Then we have to try that, we have to write the answer from our own without taking help from the paragraph, because we have understood the meaning, what is the question and what should be the answer. If it is not possible for me or for us to write the answer from ourselves, then only we can take direct help from the paragraph. So, for that, you know, we can take example of a paragraph. Here, this is a book, class 9 question bank. From there, I am taking a paragraph. First of all, let us read the paragraph, let us go through the paragraph. Paragraph is: a library is a place where different books are kept. It usually contains books of all kinds, school books, story books, dictionaries and others. There are long rows of shelves on which the books are kept. In some libraries, we can go around and choose a book. In some other libraries, we have to go to the person who is in charge of the library. Then we'll tell him what books we need. We write a number of the book, its little written here, its title and the name of the author on a piece of paper. Then we sign the paper and hand over it to the man, and he gives us the book. We can usually keep it for a week or two at our home for study. This is all about the paragraph. So, first we have read, once more let us read. A library is a place where different books are kept. It usually contains books of all kinds, school books, story books, dictionaries and others. There are long rows of shelves on which the books are kept. In some libraries, we can go around and choose a book. In some other libraries, we have to go to the person who is in charge of the library. Then we'll tell him that book we need. We'll tell him what book we need. We write a number of the book, its title and the name of the author on a piece of paper. Then we sign the paper and hand over it to the man, and he gives us the book. We can usually keep it for a week or two at our home for study. This is the paragraph for comprehension. Now, the questions, we have to go through the questions. What type of books do we usually get in a library? So, we have got the answer. All kinds of books, school books, dictionaries, story books, it is there, we have to mark it. Then how can we collect books in some other libraries from the in charge? So we know that we found it here that in some libraries we can choose from the shelves, and in some other libraries what to do? We have to go to the in charge. Then we have to give him a piece of paper where we will write the title of the book, name of the author and a serial number of the book. Then he will give it to us. So, we got it. Then once again we have to mark that portion also. Then find out the word from the passage which means a wooden furniture for keeping books. So, this we must know. Simply here going through the paragraph, what we got? Shelves. On shelves books are kept. Then books, shelves are generally, shelves are made of what? Woods. And now steel shelves are also there, but here it is said that means we have to name a furniture which is used for keeping books, and it is made of what? Wood. So it is obvious that it will be shelves. Then next question is, give the opposite number of the following. So two words have been given and we have to find out the opposite numbers of these two words. So one has been given as shelves. Shelves, this is what? Plural form. And what is the singular form of that? We must know. We have to find out. It is not there in the story. It is not there in the paragraph. The shelves. Shelves has been used, and we have to find out. We have to write from our own the singular form of shelves. Then another word has been given. The word is what? Story. We have to write the opposite number. Story is singular number, so we have to write the plural number of the word story. So, let us come to the first question. What type of books do we usually get in a library? First question. Here we got what? It usually contains books of all kinds, school books, story books, dictionaries and others. This sentence, from there we have to make the answer. So what can we make? What type of books do we usually get in a library? We usually get all kinds of books like school books, story books, dictionaries, etc. in a library. So you can write it in other way also, in your own way, how you understand, but the construction of the sentence should be correct. So we usually get, my answer, what I am saying, we usually get all kinds of books like school books, story books, dictionaries, etc. in a library. Then second question is, how can we collect books in some other libraries from the in-charge? That means it is there in the paragraph, from in-charge, how can we collect book? So here it is written that the part where from where we'll get the answer, in some other libraries we have to go to the person who is in charge of the library, then we will tell him what books we need. We write a number of the book, its title and the name of the author on a piece of paper, then we sign the paper and hand over it to the man and he gives us the book. From there we have to make the answer. What it will be? In some other libraries we are to go to the in charge of the library and we are to hand him over a piece of paper with the serial number of the book, title of the book and the name of the author with a sign also. Then the in charge of the library will hand it over to us. How can we collect books in some other libraries from the in charge? So this portion I said, from there you have to make. I made one answer, you can make it in your own way. So I said what? In some other libraries we are to go to the, in some other libraries to collect books we are to go to the in charge of the library and hand him over a paper having the title of the book, serial number of the book, the name of the author of the book and our sign. And we have to hand it over to him and then he will give us the book. Then third question is what? Find out the word from the passage which means a wooden furniture for keeping books. We know that we keep books at our homes also. Where? On shelves. So shelves are generally made of wood, but presently we can get these steel shelves are there, these iron shelves are also there. So we have to name a furniture, wooden furniture, which is used to keep books. So simply here we can say that this is what? Shelves. Then we have to give the opposite number of these two words. The words have been given to us, shelves and story. So shelves, this is a plural form, s-h-e-l-v-e-s. So this is the plural form of shelf, and story, this is singular number. So plural number of opposite number you have to write. If it is singular number then plural, then plural. If it is plural then singular. Shelves is plural, then we have to write the singular form of this shelf. And story is singular, we have to write the plural form of story. This is what? Stories. So this is all about comprehension. What to do? We have to go through the paragraph that is given to us carefully. Then we have to understand the question. Then we have to mark the places from where we can write the answer. After marking the places from where we can write the answers, we are to write the answer in our own language. Sometimes we can take help from the words given in the paragraph also. That is all about comprehension. This is very easy. The most important thing about comprehension is what? We are to understand the meaning of the paragraph first. Then we have to understand the questions. And then we have to write the answers using the paragraph. Sometimes, no, that means some questions are there, always the questions will be on the basis of the paragraph. But sometimes what happens, students go out of the paragraph and they bring some extra things to write. It should not be like that. Your answer should be to the point, how it is said in the paragraph. But you should not copy the words from the paragraph. You should write in your own words. This is all about comprehension. For that also, You can take help from the question banks or from some other places, or you can take help from your book also. You can take an extract, take a part or take a paragraph from your chapters, and then you can go through it again and again, and then you can make questions yourself, then you can write the answers also. So it is better for you to take help from the question banks, and if you can get, if you can manage the test papers, then also it is good, it is very good for you. If you can manage test papers, then there also you will get paragraphs for practicing as comprehensions. Their question paragraphs will be there and questions will be there. You have to find out the answers and you have to write them. For that you can take help from my part also. How will you get me? So it is very easy. You can write anything in the comment box regarding comprehension writing or anything. I'll be there to answer you. Then our next topic is what? Today's last topic is translation. So English, we read English as the second language. So here a question always will be there for you to translate into English. The sentences will be given in your mother tongue and you will be asked to translate them into English. For that, what to do? We must know the formation of sentences. We must know the formation of sentences. We must know the usage of tenses. We must know the voice. We must know narration. If we do not know all those things, then it will be a tough thing for us. If we know all those things, then it will be easier for us. The first and foremost thing is what? We must know the construction. How to construct a sentence, how to construct an SRT sentence, how to construct an interrogative sentence, how to construct an imperative sentence, how to construct an exclamatory sentence, how to construct an optative sentence. So we must know all the constructions. Then from the sentence itself, we will understand in which tense it should be. After understanding the tense, we can write the sentence as per the construction. For that also, what to do? You must practice again and again. Here from this question bank I am taking some sentences, and I will show you how to do. For that also, what you are to do? You are to buy or you are to manage question bank. From there you can practice it much. So first sentence is what? Ami dosham shrenite poli, othoba ami dosham shrenir chhatri. Ami dosham shrenir chhatri. Ami dosham shrenir chhatri. This sentence has been given and you were asked to translate the sentence into English. So first of all, you have to understand what type of sentence it is. It is an assertive sentence, because there is no question here, there is no order or advice, there is no wish also, and there is no certain feelings also, certain feelings also. So it is assertive. So it will be in assertive form. That means subject, verb, object. In this form we have to write this one. Now we must know the meanings. That means the English words of these words. We know ami, I, dasham, tenth. Dasham Sreni, that means 10th class. Chhatri means student. It is in that means feminine gender. Chhatro, Chhatri, same thing. Student, it is Chhatro, Chhatri, both we can indicate using what? Student. So let's try. I, present tense it is, I am a student of class 10. I am a student of class 10. This is I am dasham shrenir chhatri, or ami dasham shrenir chhatro. Ami, I am chhatri, a student of which class? Dasham shreni, of class 10. So it is Bengali construction, English construction, it is a bit different. Bengali, what we say, as for example, you take this one very simply, you can understand. Ami bhat khai. If we translate it word by word, then I rice it. I rice it. In English, we cannot write this one that way. In English, what to do? First, subject, then verb. Then we have to write what? Verb. If main verb is there, then main verb. If there is no main verb, then we have to use auxiliary verb, and it will be it will act as the main verb in the sentence. So here the same thing happened. Ami dashom shreni chhatri, here there is no verb, so we have to supply a verb present tense with I, first person singular number. We have to use what? Am. And am here, originally am is an auxiliary verb, but here it will act as the main verb. So I am a student of class 10. Next sentence we can take. তিনি বললেন অনুগ্রহ করে আমাকে সাহায্য করো. তিনি বললেন কমা ইনভার্টেড কমা অনুগ্রহ করে আমাকে সাহায্য আমাকে সাহায্য করো. দাড়ি দেন ইনভার্টেড কমা ক্লোজড. দিস সেন্টেন্স উই গট. ফর দ্যাট নো উই মাস্ট নো নারেশন. সো ফ্রম দিস ইনভার্টেড কমা হোয়াট উই আন্ডারস্টুড, দিস ইজ এ ডিরেক্ট নারেশন. সো ওয়েন উইল রাইট দ্য সেন্টেন্স, ওয়েন উইল ট্রান্সলেট দ্য সেন্টেন্স ইন টু ইংলিশ, উই হ্যাভ টু ট্রান্সলেট ইট ইন টু ডিরেক্ট নারেশন. তিনি বললেন, তিনি হি বললেন সেইড, দেন কমা, দেন ইনভার্টেড কমা ওয়ান্স এগেইন. অনুগ্রহ করে মিন্স দয়া করে, মিন্স হোয়াট? প্লিজ. ওয়েন উই আস্ক সামবডি ইন ইংলিশ নো অনুগ্রহ করে, সো উই হ্যাভ টু ইউজ দ্য ইংলিশ ওয়ার্ড হোয়াটস? প্লিজ. প্লিজ হেল্প, সাহায্য করা. হেল্প কাহাকে? আমাকে. প্লিজ হেল্প মি ফুল স্টপ. প্লিজ হেল্প মি, অনুগ্রহ করে আমাকে সাহায্য করো, অথবা দয়া করে আমাকে সাহায্য করো. ওকে, দেন অ্যানাদার এক্সাম্পল উই ক্যান টেক. শিলচরে একটি বিশ্ববিদ্যালয় আছে. শিলচরে একটি বিশ্ববিদ্যালয় আছে. সো উই হ্যাভ টু ট্রান্সলেট দিস ওয়ান ইন ইংলিশ. সো হিয়ার উই হ্যাভ টু ইউজ হোয়াট? ইন্ট্রোডাক্টরি দেয়ার, ইট উইল বি দ্য সাবজেক্ট. দেয়ার ইজ আ ইউনিভার্সিটি, there is a university in Silchar. AY university U is a vowel, and we know that when a vowel is there as the first letter of a word, and we have to use what? N. But here we have used what? A. Because why? Pronunciation of U is like U. When the pronunciation of U is like U, we have to use A before that. That's why you have used what? There is a university in Silchar. Another example we can take. Tumi ki shatar katte jano? তুমি কি সাঁতার কাটতে জানো? কোয়েশ্চন মার্ক. দিস ইজ এন ইন্টারগেটিভ সেন্টেন্স. সো হোয়াট টাইপ অফ ইন্টারগেটিভ ইট ইজ? তুমি কি সাঁতার কাটতে জানো? উই ক্যান আনসার ইন ইয়েস অর নো. সো হোয়েন ইট ইজ নোন টু অল অফ আস, হোয়েন উই ক্যান আনসার এ কোয়েশ্চন ইন ইয়েস অর নো, দিস ইজ হোয়াট ইয়েস নো টাইপ কোয়েশ্চন. অ্যান্ড ইয়েস নো টাইপ কোয়েশ্চনস অলওয়েজ স্টার্টস উইথ অক্সিলারি ভার্ব. সো তুমি কি সাঁতার কাটতে জানো? সো দিস ইজ ইয়েস নো টাইপ কোয়েশ্চন, ইউ হ্যাভ টু স্টার্ট ইট উইথ অক্সিলারি ভার্ব. সো হুইচ অক্সিলারি ভার্ব ইট উইল বি? বিকজ হিয়ার দেয়ার ইজ নো অক্সিলারি ভার্ব. তুমি কি সাঁতার কাটতে জানো? দেয়ার ইজ নো অক্সিলারি ভার্ব, দ্যাটস ওয়াই ইউ হ্যাভ টু সাপ্লাই এ অক্সিলারি ভার্ব অফ আওয়ার ওন অ্যাকর্ডিং টু দ্য টেন্স অফ দ্য সেন্টেন্স. দিস ইজ হোয়াট in present tense, the question has been asked in present tense. So, do you know সাঁতার কাটতে তুমি কি জানো ডু ইউ নো তুমি কি জানো কি করতে সাঁতার কাটতে হাউ টু সুইম ডু ইউ নো হাউ টু সুইম সো উই ডু নট ট্রান্সলেট দ্য সেন্টেন্স ইন টু ইংলিশ ওয়ার্ড বাই ওয়ার্ড উই আর টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দ্য মিনিং অ্যান্ড দেন উই আর টু ইউজ ইট ইন ইংলিশ কনস্ট্রাকশন তুমি কি সাঁতার কাটতে জানো ডু ইউ নো হাউ টু সুইম অ্যানাদার এক্সাম্পল As the last example, I am showing you. Amora station e pouchar purbe train ti ছেড়ে দিল দিস সেন্টেন্স ইন উই আর আস্ক টু চেঞ্জ দ্য ট্রান্সলেট ইন টু ইংলিশ উই আর আস্ক টু ট্রান্সলেট দ্য সেন্টেন্স ইন টু ইংলিশ আমরা স্টেশনে পৌঁছার পূর্বে ট্রেনটি ছেড়ে দিল হেয়ার উই হ্যাভ আন্ডারস্টুড উই গট টু ওয়ার্কস হ্যাভ বিন ডান ওয়ান ইজ ওয়াট আওয়ার রিচিং টু দ্য স্টেশন অ্যান্ড অ্যানাদার ওয়ান ইজ ওয়াট লিভিং অফ দ্য ট্রেন সো উই নো দ্যাট ওয়েন টু অ্যাক্টিভিটিস হ্যাভ বিন ডান ইন পাস্ট টেন্স Out of that, which one had been done earlier, that one will be in past perfect form, and which one had been done later, that one will be in past indefinite form. So here, before our reaching, purbe means what? Before. Before our reaching, the train left. So this work was done before this. That's why this part will be in past perfect form. So the train had left. Then what? Before we reached the station, the train, this one, the leaving of train was done earlier, so it will be in past tense, the train, past perfect tense, the train had left. And the our reaching to the station, it was done later, so it will be in past indefinite form. So amora station e pouchar purbe train ti chhere dilo the train had left before we reached the station. Here amora station e pouchar por train ti chhere dilo if it is then what to do one thing very careful we have to be very careful when before we have to use then past perfect will be used before the word before and when after is used then we have to use past perfect after the word after. So here before is used, so we have used past perfect before this had left. And if it is after, then past perfect will be here. So let's try this one once again. Amara station e pouchar por train ti chhere dilo. Amara station e pouchar por train ti chhere dilo. Then here what happened? Our reaching to the station was done earlier. And then the train left. So the train left because why it was done later that's why it will be in past tense and why we are using past indefinite earlier because we are using after here if we use after then past indefinite will be earlier and if we use before then past perfect will be earlier so here we have used after that's why we are using past indefinite first the train left after we had reached the station. This is all about translation. For that also, what to do? You have to practice again and again. We must know the English of the words, what are given in the sentences. So these are common words. These will be common words what will get in your exam paper, question papers. And we know when we'll get sentences, now we will find that means the English of each and every words are known to us. Just we must know the what construction, how to construct a sentence as per the formation of the sentence, assertive, imperative, interrogative, exclamatory. On the basis of them, we have to construct them. Word by word translation is not right. We should not translate into English word by word. We have to understand the meaning, then we have to construct the sentence according to the construction in English language. For that also you can take help from this question bank of class 9 or 10. There also you will get a lot of questions, lot of translation to translate, a lot of sentences to translate into English. So for today up to this, and if you face any problem or if you get any sentence, the translation of that you are not getting, you can write in the comment box. I am there, I can give you the answer and I can make you understand also. So thank you once again.